Okay, if you have gotten the largest lab package, first of all, congratulations. We're gonna have way more data and information on you than you've probably ever seen. The first test is a genetic test. You've seen this box in the first video. The first video, we're only doing your methylation pathways and your energy pathways. This one adds how well you handle internal and external inflammation, and it also has brain chemistry pathways. So somebody who's suffering from anxiety, depression, this could tell us if you make or break down serotonin properly. It could tell us why and which parent, or if a parent had it. It's really great. But same as the first genetic test in the first video, it's just a cheek swab. You just do 30 seconds. We found singing happy birthday in your head on one side. You go under the gums, above the teeth, and 30 seconds over here. And then you just simply put it in the biohazard box, put it in the mailing bag, and just mail it off. This one, the only difference is the full panel. So 55 genes instead of, I believe, 18. So big difference. It's gonna give us a lot more data. The second test in the final lab package, the third, the platinum lab package, is a hair analysis test. Now, if I ran this, I'm suspecting possible heavy metal toxicity. So headaches, migraines, neurological issues, tics, numbness, tingling, somebody who's had a lot of amalgam fillings, somebody who's had a lot of vaccinations at once, and you're a poor detoxer, or we suspect you're a poor detoxer, you could have heavy metal build up in your body. I very much have a lot of personal experience with this. My father had mercury poisoning and was misdiagnosed with MS. It was the mercury that was going through his blood-brain barrier and causing sclerosing, a scar tissue in his brain. So he had heavy metal removed, did some chelation therapy, detoxed it, and a lot of his MS symptoms went away. There was some permanent damage, but I mean, literally one whole side of his body was numb, went away. So I really like testing for this, but I only run it if I think it's necessary or somebody, you know, possibly has the toxicity. Interesting test, it's a hair analysis test. Yes, you can use hair from anywhere in your body. No, it cannot be processed. So if you dye your hair, you need to possibly take this into your hairdresser and have her or him cut new growth. Okay, new growth. So if you have highlights, any type of hair dye, even if it's hemp and natural, we don't want those chemicals in this test. We want a clean test. You can use underarm hair, leg hair, pubic hair. You can use any hair. The thing is, you're gonna have this little tiny scale. See how cute that is? And you'll just set it on a flat surface. And there's a spot where you put the hair, and as soon as it tilts, you've got enough hair. So this will make kind of more sense on a flat surface, but yep, you'll put it here and then eventually you'll put enough hair that it tilts, and that's when you've had enough hair. I've done this test. I had them take a couple chunks from different parts, and it wasn't a lot. It wasn't noticeable. So I took like a piece like this, maybe a piece like that, and then like one from the very back, just small little pieces. I would, you know, get the edge, and then it piles up pretty quick. And this is gonna tell us mercury, lead, arsenic, all kinds of amazing, great information of chemicals that we could be exposed to, heavy metals and chemicals. I could go on and on about what we found with this, but a lot of people that have worked in factories have a lot of heavy metal exposure. Painters, really industrial jobs, I found that heavy metals and these toxicities is their problem for fatigue, insomnia, neurological problems. It's great data. So I'm excited to see that test on you. And if you have any questions, call or email us. Thanks.